हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू स्टैंडर्ड 8 सब्जेक्ट ज्योग्राफी, लेसन नंबर 7 पॉपुलेशन. नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, वी ऑल नो व्हाट इज पॉपुलेशन, राइट? नाउ हाउ वी विल एबल टू नो दैट व्हाट इज पॉपुलेशन? ओके, लेट मी गिव यू सम एग्जांपल्स. Like if I ask you all how many students were there in your class, out of the total number, how many are the boys and how many are the girls, right? And what is the total strength of students in the class in the last year? Which class has the maximum strength of the students? Which class has the most absentees? So all this give us some of the number, right? Number of person absent, number of students present, or number of boys in the class, or number of girls in the class. So we get the exact number according to the question asked from the person, right? Now, in a similar manner, information can be obtained about the population of a village, taluka, district, state, nation, and the whole world. While obtaining this information, we have to consider age and sex ratio, literacy, etc. So what is the age of the person? What is the sex of the person? That he is a male or she is a female. And we have to see the literacy rate, that how many are literate, how many are educated. Now, several factors are responsible for the development of a region. Out of these, population is an important factor. While studying this lesson, that is population of any region, the following points we are going to study, which are the 4 points, that is population growth, population distribution, population density, and the structure of the population. Okay, come on, let's start with the first point, that is population growth. Now, it is obvious that sometimes there is a decrease in population and at the times there is an increase in the population. The increase or the decrease is related to the following factors. Let us see what are the following factors which are related to the increase and the decrease of the population. First is birth rate. Now, the number of live birth per 1000 people in a year shows the birth rate. Understood? Now, second point is death rate. The number of deaths per 1000 people in a year shows the ratio of the death rate. And life expectancy, the average lifespan of an individual expected in an area at the time of birth. Next is migration. Now, this is the movement of an individual, or it can be a group, out of an area to other, that is another area, is called migration. Now, when people move into a region from outside for residence, that is to stay, it is called in migration. And when people move out of a region for residential purpose, it is called out migration. Now, all these factors which we have seen affect the population, that is birth rate, death rate, life expectancy, migration. So all these factors are affecting the population growth. The difference between the birth rate and the death rate is clearly responsible for the natural changes in population. Similarly, the migration of an individual or a group constantly result in the change of population. When people constantly move, or a group of people constantly moves, for example, if one day one family is going, other day other family is going, or In one day, many people or many individual go from one place to another. These all affect in the population. Now, on the other hand, a controlled growth of population will lead to the availability of resources in the right proportion. A controlled population is an indicator of the development of a region. Now, if the unchecked, that is the growth of population, is not checked properly, it puts pressure on what? On the resources available in a region, and it goes out of control. So we have to maintain the controlled population because it is the indicator of the development of a region. Okay, moving ahead with the next point, that is distribution of population. Now let us see how is the population distributed. When the grains of chawli are scattered over two areas of different sizes, in the larger area, the distribution appears sparse. It means it appears as a short because it is distributed widely in the different sizes. So it becomes short. Similarly, we can understand that the distribution of population in a region, same regions are mountainous region while others are flat plains, and these geographical conditions vary, means it differs from place to place. Some regions are well endowed with natural resources, means some regions are having lot of natural resources available on the land, and while others have limited resources, means there is natural resources less available in that particular region. Now all these conditions affect the distribution of population. Where there is natural resources are limited, there will be less population, and where the natural resources are endowed, there are many natural resources available for the people, that region or that area will have the population growth. Now, in areas with abundant resources, naturally the population is more, and in these areas there is dense population distribution. In areas with scarce resources, that is less resources available, unfavorable climate and undulating terrain etc., the population distribution is less over there. Now here in this picture you can see there are various factors which are affecting the distribution of population. There are four factors: physical factor, economic factor, political factor and social factor. Physical factors contains location, relief, climate, soil and mineral resources. In the next factor, that is economic factor, agriculture, industry, urbanization, transport, markets. Next factor, that is political factor, contains wars, political instability and government policies. Last factor is social factor. It contains race, religion, language, customs and traditions. Now let us see the third main point, that is density of population. Now the ratio of the population of a country to its area is population density. While discussing this population distribution, density of a population is also considered. The density can be calculated like this. It is the formula. Here you can see density of population is equal to population of a region upon area of a region. Now there is a table given there in your textbook page number 44. You can try it for the example. Now from this area of region and its population, one can calculate how many people live in a square kilometer area. The density of population is not the same everywhere. In some regions, the area is small but the population is very large. For examples like Kerala, in other regions, द एरिया इज लार्ज बट द पॉपुलेशन इज स्मॉल. देयरफॉर द डेंसिटी ऑफ पॉपुलेशन इज लो. फॉर एग्जाम्पल राजस्थान. नाउ लेट अस सी द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ पॉपुलेशन. पॉपुलेशन कैन बी सब डिवाइडेड इंटू वेरियस कैटेगरीज. नाउ देर आर वेरियस फैक्टर्स फॉर विच वी कैन डिवाइड द स्ट्रक्चर टू कैलकुलेट द पॉपुलेशन. बाई स्टडिंग दिस कोरिलेशन बिटवीन दिस सब डिविजन्स एंड अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चर एंड क्वालिटी ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन इज पॉसिबल. सो वॉट आर द फैक्टर्स लेट अस सी. फर्स्ट इज सेक्स रेशियो. नाउ लेट अस सी वॉट इज सेक्स रेशियो. एज पर द जेंडर दैट इज मेल और फीमेल पॉपुलेशन कैन बी डिवाइडेड एंड दिस इज द नेचुरल डिविजन विच कैन बी इजीली अंडरस्टूड बाय एवरीवन. इन द पॉपुलेशन व्हेन बोथ द जेंडर्स आर अराउंड द सेम नंबर व्हाट इट इंडिकेट्स. इट इंडिकेट्स दैट देर इज अ बैलेंस पॉपुलेशन. नाउ इन पॉपुलेशन स्टडीज द रेशियो ऑफ मेन एंड वुमेन इज कंसिडर्ड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सो द रेशियो कैन बी कैलकुलेटेड बाय दिस फॉर्मूला. सेक्स रेशियो इज इक्वल टू टोटल नंबर ऑफ फीमेल्स अपॉन टोटल नंबर ऑफ मेल्स इंटू 100 इंटू 1000. नाउ फॉर एवरी 1000 मेल द नंबर ऑफ फीमेल इज लेस. सो द सेक्स रेशियो इज सेट टू बी लो एंड व्हेन फॉर एवरी 1000 मेल द नंबर ऑफ फीमेल इज मोर देन द सेक्स रेशियो इज सेट टू बी हाई. यू कैन सी इन योर पेज नंबर 45 ऑफ योर टेक्स्ट बुक दैट इज 7.3. नाउ लेट अस सी द ज्योग्राफिकल एक्सप्लेनेशन. इन रीजन्स वेयर द प्रोपोर्शन of female is more than the males, the outmigration of men is high. The outmigration is very often for what? For employment purpose, because male people migrate from one region or from one area to the another region for employment purpose, that is for job purpose. For example, Kerala. But where the proportion of female is less than males, in most cases the birth rate of female is less. Now when we see that female population is less, so what can be considered? It can be considered that in most cases the female birth rate is less. Thank you.